I still remember my very first memory, that was to celebrate my 18th birthday with my very new friends which I made in my university hostel, because I newly shifted to a new city and started a new journey. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel of Legal Humming. This is me, Deshna Jain, and first of all, congratulations to all of you for making it to your very new mesmerizing journey of your life. This journey of your life is not less than your favorite car road trip which you always wanted to be on with your friends, your girlfriend, your boyfriend, or with your family, or with anybody you love the most. In this road trip of yours, you're gonna make million and million of memories, and you're gonna meet new people, you're gonna explore, and you're gonna become mature, and you're gonna be more intelligent, more responsible, more lovable, and a lot more altogether. Now, since you are on a road trip journey, you might face some speed breakers on your way, and you have to put some brakes to stop your car or to get your car in control. But to solve that issue and to make your journey fast, flow going and very smooth journey, here I am guiding you up with some of my experiences which I faced when I was in my first year, and it took me 1.5 years to get all those things into process. So let's get started. So firstly, now as you have taken your admission at your very respective universities and now you are well settled there and you might be starting with your classes very, very soon, I am assuming that you went through a lot of competitive exams before, like CLAT and all, and you were at your very stressed level of your life. So now calm down, breathe and enjoy this very new journey and relax. Remember to love what you do and where you are. Forget all those things which happened to you. If you made it to the NLU, congratulations, you guys, your hard work really paved off. But if you didn't, that is okay, your life doesn't stop here. Remember that, keep on going, you have to hustle really hard now. So enjoy and love what you do and where you are. Secondly, start your journey with the purest mind, without any negative thoughts and without any predetermined destination. It is really good if you have your own dreams. For example, I want to become a judge in future and that is why I have taken law. But it's okay. This is your time to become the explorer of your life. Be that one irritating Dora the Explorer, or in fact Bunny from Ye Jawani Hai Diwani, and explore the fields of law, because trust me guys, you have no clue how much opportunity this profession is gonna give you. Thirdly, understand what kind of advocate you want to become. Respect is something which you have to learn in your legal profession. Respecting your seniors, your juniors and everyone around, because respecting will never make you smaller in anyone's eyes. When you respect others, you make good contacts, you make healthy relationships, people start liking you, and this helps you in your future and your career building. Trust me, even when I joined my first year, I used to think that legal profession is all about being bossy and being strict and being rude and all that. But it is not how it works, you guys. In this profession, more you are polite, more respectful you are, more respecting you are, people love you, people enjoy working with you, people bond with you, and you make a stronger career. So respecting is very, very important and you should always implement it in your life, especially as now you have taken legal profession as your own career. Firstly, now that you have taken legal profession as your career, you might be becoming a very, very involving and very, very busy person in your life, because you might be surrounded with a lot of lectures, your assignments, your other competitions and a lot more. But in this process, never forget who you are, what you enjoy, what you like doing. For example, if you have a hobby of painting, continue doing that. Make some time out of your life to pursue that as well, as a hobby, as your passion, and whatsoever you want to call it. Never lose the personality which you govern. Fifth, when you start with your classes and your education, you'll understand the value of case laws in this profession. For that, I have this book recommendation which looks like this. This is by Samarth Agrawal. He was the former civil judge. This was my holy grail when I was in my first year. This book contains a lot of case laws on every possible topic. So you are in your first year, right? So you might be coming up with contract laws and law of torts and all that. So this book even has those topics, and you'll find every case law in this book related to law of torts, contract, and every subject possible. So this will help you at your exams time. You know what happens, no matter what, how motivated you are right now, at the end we are students and we are gonna be like those who study at the very last moment. This is gonna be your holy grail at that time, trust me on that, because this book is gonna be your life savior. Now the very next point. जब मैंने बात कर ही ली है एक शॉर्टकट मेथड की और आपको एक टिप दे ही दिया है और एक बुक रिकमेंडेशन दे ही दिया है जहाँ पर आप केस लॉज को देख सकते हो, देन आई वुड ऑल्सो टेल यू द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ एग्जामिनेशंस. यू माइट बी थिंकिंग कि 12th तक हम लोग जितना स्कोर करते हैं वो हमारी लाइफ का सब पार्ट डिटरमाइन कर चुका है. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, आपके कॉलेज मार्क्स भी वैल्यू गेन करेंगे. अब मान लो कि एक कंपनी प्लेसमेंट के लिए आ रही है और आपके बराबर का ही एक इंसान है हु हैज़ गिवन अ ग्रेट इंटरव्यू एज यू हैव गिवन. नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ द पर्सन वुड बी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ मार्क्स. दैट कुड बी द एक्सट्रीम पॉसिबिलिटी. सो फ्रॉम द वेरी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर ट्राई टू मेंटेन योर CGPA और GPA, हाउ एवर योर यूनिवर्सिटी वर्क्स लाइक इन देयर डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ मार्क्स. मेंटेन दैट, एटलीस्ट बी above 8.5 to 8.8 CGPA, so that you are at least on your very very basic level and you are not messing up with your life. Now the very next point is to be practical with your life, not just to focus on your theoretical part. You should always and always start building a habit of learning practicality. Now I'm first generation lawyer and there was nobody who could help me with pleading and drafts making. So for that, I just discovered this book and I fell in love with it, you guys. I still do get through this book when I need it, and this really helped me out in my first year. Now this book is something which will help you with all the practical drafting. So for example, in your theoretical subject you would be learning what is contract making and what is the need of contract, what are contracts and all that, but contract banate kaise hai practically, this book can be a help for that. So that is why I recommend it to each and every one of you. Now since hum log practicality ki baat kar rahe hain, to let's move to the very next point, which is our 8th point and which is also the very last point for this video, is to understand the value of participating in competitions. Jab hum participate karte hain competitions mein, there is one misconception jo mujh mein bhi tha aur aap mein bhi ho sakta hai shayad, that the legal profession is all about speaking skills. Mujhe us time koi guide karne wala nahi tha, but this I can make sure and tell you from the very beginning of yours that writing skills are as important as your speaking skills in this profession. Start from your very basic intra competitions, then you can move further to the inter and then international competitions, and this is how you'll take your very small steps in this journey and you'll ace this journey for sure. So yeah, that's it guys about this video. I hope I was able to remove all the speed breakers from your very smooth journey and now you don't have to put any kind of brakes. But if you still have any questions, any suggestions or any comments to make, please, please do that in the comment section. I love reading all your comments and I do like to respond to them as well. So please make sure you do that if you have any of your concerns in your mind or anything going in your mind right now. It's okay. Enjoy your first year journey. You are starting with an amazing journey and you have chosen an amazing profession, and this for sure I can tell you. So love your way, love wherever you are, and keep in mind all the points that we discussed in this video. And I hope that I was helpful to you guys in some or the other way, and this video turned out to be a good motivation, or to say a good video which could help you out with the very beginning of your journey. If you like me and this video, then please, please, please give this video a big thumbs up, and also do subscribe to my channel for more such videos, and I shall see you in my next video then. So this is me, Deshna Jain, signing off now. Bye guys.